Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to be doing a review of the new NARS Atomic Balm Face and Eye Palette. Also, towards the end of the video, I will share my thoughts with you on the NARS Full Vinyl Lip Lacquers. These aren't as new as this palette, but they are pretty new, so I do have some opinions I'd like to share with you guys. So if you're interested, make sure you just keep watching. Alright, so let's start off with the most important part of this video, the Atomic Blonde Eye and Face Palette. So, some basic facts about this palette. It came out about a week ago. You can get it on the NARS website and Sephora.com right now. It is limited edition, so if you do want it, get your hands on it now. It is $59. Apparently, it has a $155 value to it. And basically, it is described as a multi-use palette for smoldering bronze eyes and cheek look. Alright, so let's get into the packaging of this product. Very similar to most of the NARS packaging, just very sleek, very beautiful, so photogenic. And then on the back, you have the names. It's always really hard to open NARS packaging. You really gotta dig your nail in there to get it open. But when you open up, it is going to reveal inside two face products and four eyeshadows. Really quickly, as you can see, you clearly have a bronzer, a highlight, and four eyeshadows. Four of these products are limited edition and special to this palette. The other two are found in the regular line. So the two that are found in the regular line are Galapagos, which I actually think I do have or did have in the past, and then Isolde 2. These two are the only non-limited edition products. Alright, so I do have some swatches for you guys right now, as you can see. The first four are the eyeshadows and the last two are the highlighter and bronzer. So finish-wise on this palette, you do have one glitter eyeshadow and then you have two metallic shimmer colors and one color that is like a matte base but with a lot of shimmer slash glitters in it, and that's Galapagos. Then of course you have the highlighter, which of course is shimmery, and the bronzer, which isn't matte. It does have a little bit of like a sheen to it, so it's not matte, but it's the closest thing you're going to get in matte with this palette. So formulation wise, let's talk about the eyeshadows first. So these two eyeshadows right here feel like butter. They are the smoothest shadows I think I've ever felt from NARS in a palette. I don't remember ever feeling two eyeshadows that felt just like straight cream. They're absolutely beautiful, absolutely lovely on the lid. They went on so beautiful and pigmented, and that was with a brush, not my finger. Now the glitter color over here, this is Kink. Not the best formula if you ask me. What's good about it is you can get a subtle glitter if you're not too into glitter. I have that as kind of a lip topper on my lid, and I think that's one of the best ways you can use this shadow. So I used this as the base color and this as the glitter topper. I used my finger so there wasn't much fallout, and it looks really pretty over, but don't expect to get this color on your eyelid. To get that color, you're going to have to put a glitter glue down and then use your finger to stamp it on. So if you do that, you won't have any issues with the shadow, but it's not the best glittery kind of formula I've ever used, but you can definitely make it work. And I do like that you can kind of build it from something soft to something a little bit more pigmented depending how you apply it. But yeah, as like a subtle lid color, lid topper, I love it. And Galapagos, you can't really tell that it has those gold shimmers on the lid too much. If you packed it on, you could tell there were gold glitters in it, but as like an outer corner defining crease color, it works fine, so don't even worry about that. Now the highlight right here, which is called Last Call, not my favorite highlighter to be honest from them. This formula is different than their new highlighters that they just came out with, which were a lot more pressed in, and I don't know, they just have a complete different finish on the cheek. They're a lot more blinding. This isn't a super blinding highlight, which is not a bad thing. It is buildable. Applying it to the cheek, it didn't apply as smooth as their new highlighters. It did take a little bit of building, and I did kind of worry that it felt a little bit chunky on my cheeks. It just wasn't as smooth upon application, and it does show a little bit of texture. So it's not my favorite highlighter formula, but if you're using this palette, I don't mind reaching for this as my highlighter, but it's not kind of my preference for a highlighter. And the bronzer, this is in the shade Unleashed. If you don't like bronzers with a bit of a reddish undertone, you probably won't like this bronzer. It blended out beautifully. The formula was fine. It's not as good as the bronzers in my Bored to Plague palette. I loved this. This palette has the best formula for bronzers and highlighters. Complete different formula than that palette. It works, it blends. A little bit more red toned. I don't think it's going to look very good on very fair skin tones. It's going to pool very red. But for medium skin tones, I think this is a really good bronzer. For me, it's not my favorite shade of bronzer, but it does provide a lot of warmth because of that redness, but you just gotta use a light hand if you're as light as me. So, I mean, the basics of this formulation are, these are different than the new formulas, but I mean, I do like it. I just think that this palette is very well suited for medium skin tones. For light skin tones, it works just fine. I have no complaints, but I think someone with a medium skin tone, this is going to be the most flattering on you. And I loved the way these applied to the eyes. Even this one that I kind of complained about. They're all super blendable. They're very easy to work with. I just created this bomb look. Like, I'm obsessed with this bronzy eye I have going on right now. So if you really want a bronze palette, this is super good. The quality is good. It's not super unique. Not gonna lie, it's not super unique. You probably don't need it. $59 is a lot to pay for a palette, but the quality of this isn't going to disappoint you. This is a good palette to travel with, honestly. It's kind of just that bronzy look in one palette. So if you're looking for that, go ahead and pick this up. So now I'm going to kind of go into what I did to get this look and what colors I used. So of course, to start off, I used the bronzer in the shade Unleashed, and I built that up around the perimeter of my face. I did realize that I did pool very red, and I wasn't too into it, so I did have to take a little bit of powder to clean up underneath my contour line. And then I used the highlighter in this palette, Last Call, and I just applied that to the high points of my cheeks, my nose, Cupid's bow. It worked out very well. Not my favorite highlighter, not my favorite highlighter formula, but it is buildable and it looks fine, but it does emphasize my texture a little bit, so not my favorite formula. So to start off with my eyes, I started off with the bronze color, and I used that in my crease. It is the perfect crease color. Even though it does have a slight sheen to it, it's not completely matte. It works out just fine as a transition slash crease color, and it blended out beautifully. I then went in with the shade Galapagos, and I put that in my outer corner just for some definition. Again, it's not a typical matte shadow, but it looks just fine. Nothing to worry about. I then took the shade that shade right there, and I put that all over my lid. This is the kind of color that I thought you could only really apply with your finger to get that full pigment, but no, with a brush, it applied just as beautifully. Applied like butter. Love this shade. I then took that metallic shade, Kink, and I used my finger and I just patted that all over my lid to give a finish off of glitter as a lid topper, and I really love it for that. I really think it's a great finishing touch to a really bronze, deep, smoky eye. And then I took the lightest shade for the eyeshadows, an Icon, and I put that underneath my brow bone and my inner corner. Personally, since I am lighter, I would prefer a lighter color, so I did go in with the highlighter shade, but if you are medium skin tone, that shade works perfect as a highlighter for your eyes. And on my lower lash line, I just used the bronzer and Galapagos, you know, along my lower lash line. And then I went off camera and I finished the look. Overall, my thoughts on this palette, I'm so ridiculously into it. I think it's the perfect palette for summer if you're into that summer bronze look. The colors in here aren't particularly unique. I definitely have colors like this, I'm not gonna lie, but I just like that it's here all in one and you don't have to think about it. You just know if you want a bronze smoky eye, you can go for this, and the quality of this is really good. Definitely gets a thumbs up for me. $59 for a palette like this is pricey. So it's up to you if you need it or not, but I personally am super into it and I'm glad that I picked this up. So really quickly, I am going to talk about the NARS Full Vinyl Lip Colors that I do have. So I did pick up 4, and they come in this beautiful packaging with a silver topper, which is a very nice change for NARS packaging. There are a lot of colors online, a lot more than 4. But the ones that I did pick up, going from the lightest to the darkest, we have At First Sight, Santo Domingo, Cape Town, and Abruzzo. I picked up 3 with that really metallic glossy finish, and then 1 which is more of a flat color. The second shade here, Santo Domingo, absolutely beautiful color, full pigmentation on your lips. This is the color you're gonna see on your lips, so I really do like it, and like I said, full pigmentation. The color At First Sight, this is definitely more of a lip topper. It's gonna look good over every lip color and give you a nice golden shift to your lip. Cape Town, which is on top of the lipstick I have today, this will look pretty under a lighter lip color. It kind of loses its shift with the darker the color you put on, but it did put a pretty gold gloss over my lips that I am into. But like I said, I think this would look better under a lighter lip color than the one I have now. And Abruzzo, this is beautiful all on its own. Oh my gosh, it's like this metallic deep rose gold, almost magenta. Love this one. So these aren't sticky. They have the perfect amount of pigmentation, and wow, I just really like the way they feel on my lips. They're very, very smooth. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Remember to subscribe to my channel and comment down below any questions you may have for me. I would be happy to answer them for you. Yeah, I know I've been going kind of review crazy. It's not stopping. I have a couple more reviews I want to film, and then I'll chill out a little bit. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Have a great day. Bye.